Hey guys, how's it going? Scott here from Scott's Bass Lessons again. Sorry for this weird angle that I'm recording this at. I just wanted to fit all my pedal board in and me. So this is the best thing I could come up with. So this video is about my pedal board. I get asked a lot of questions about what gear I use, so I thought I'd just do one specifically on what pedals I use. I don't use every pedal on every gig. I've got, you know, different pedals that I like for different gigs. So, but I do cart this around with me everywhere, unfortunately, so I've always got, you know, a pedal for different situations. So the pedal board goes like this: bass into normally a tuner. It's not in there at the minute, but it's just a normal Boss chromatic tuner. And these are great because obviously with stage lights and stuff like that, your bass can go out of tune, so it's important to be able to tune on the fly. And if you hit this, it mutes your bass in between songs and you can tune without the dreaded, you know, in between songs, so you can't have that. So this is what this is used for. Then I go into a Boss line selector. I'm going to come back to that in a minute. So forget about the line selector for now. From the line selector, I go into an octave OC2, which is a Boss. Now, this I use generally for sort of like a synthy bass sound. They're really popular with bass players. Loads of guys use them, and there's a setting that everybody seems to use. On the pedal, there's an octave one and an octave two. Octave one on the left. Octave two, sorry, on the left, and octave one on the right. So octave two you have all the way off, octave one all the way up, and then the direct level, which is your normal bass signal, you turn that all the way off. Okay, so my clean signal sounds like this, with the octave on, you can hear it's a great synth bass sound now. It tracks really well. The only problem is, if you play down here, it just turns into utter mud. So you've got to sort of, you know, play around the 12th fret. You can get away with the C on the E string. It kind of gets muddy as you go down there. So that's what I use the octave to. So it's clean signal again. Now the distortion is a DS1 Boss, and I don't particularly use this on its own. I only use it to give the octave a little bit more bite, so I'm using that synth sound with the octave, the distortion on, sorry. That, you know, even more of a synthy bass sound. That's what I use that for. So that's these two pedals. So I usually either use the octave on its own or both on at the same time, and that's great because they're next to each other and I can tread on them together. Next in line is the Mark Bass synth pedal, which I'll just get the level right because the level might be a bit too loud. It's a real keyboardy sound. Real Stevie Wonder, you know, 70s keyboard sound. I do have issues with this. You have to plug it into your computer to really be able to mess around with the parameters via USB. So I'm not really into that because I like to do it on a gig and I don't particularly want to carry a laptop around into gig situations and sort of have to fiddle around like that. So I think this is going to have to go and be replaced with something else that I'm kind of searching for at the minute. And with that, you can play down here. The tracking's quite well. So that's what I use that for. Now, next to this is the Mooga Fooga low pass filter. Can you see that? There you go. Mooga Fooga low pass filter, which is a low pass filter. There you go, strangely enough. And I control this with this Roland foot pedal here, which looks like a wah-wah pedal, but it isn't. And this works great in conjunction with the Mark bass. Okay, so what I'm going to stand up now just to show you what it does. Hopefully I'll be out of the way of the video, or my feet won't be anyway. So if I put the low pass filter on, okay, and then put my foot on this wah-wah looking type pedal, it does this basically. Let's turn that up a little bit. You can really hear that. Yeah, so you get that. That kind of thing. And then that goes into the TC, oh, hang on, I'll get back down. That goes into the TC electronic flashback, which I use for delays. I'd really like a pedal where it has a delay pedal where it has presets. The problem with this pedal for me is, and it's nothing to do with TC, it's my fault, I bought the wrong pedal. This has got knobs, so if any of the knobs get knocked or anything like that, it means the speed of the actual delay changes. So if I'm playing in a song where the delay needs to be a part of the actual bass line, so instead of using it just for an effect, I'm using it within the bass line. If I knock one of these knobs, the speed goes off and, you know, all that kind of thing. Blech. Bad stuff happens, basically. So I'm going to replace that with maybe something else that TC make, or another delay pedal that I can just have presets and it's just digital, and I know when I switch on the button it'll be a certain tempo. So, and then what else is next? Oh, now we've got the octobass over here. Now what I need to tell you about is the line selector. On some of the gigs I do, it's kind of dubby, reggae or dubstep kind of vibe. Now, one thing that's really important in that style of music is to keep the bottom end of the bass line. And unfortunately, when I've got all these things on here, the bottom end of the actual signal kind of gets zapped. So what I do is I split my signal via this line selector here. So I go into the line selector and come out of the line selector, which takes me through here, or this set of effects. Then that goes to my amp, or to the out front of the desk, or something like that. And then the other output that comes out of the line selector goes into the octobass pedal here, EBS octobass. And what I'll do is I'll show you both signals. So for instance, just on my this signal I've got here, is this. Oh, let's turn that down a bit. Is there. Just there, but I can turn that all the way down, so that's gone. And then my other signal is this one, so that's just sub bass. So that's going on all the time, unaffected when all these are on. So now I can mix the two. So this is the two signals mixed, okay? So the, well, I'll just play it. So signal one. Signal two. And then both of them mixed. In conjunction with the Mooga Fooga, and then I'll put the flashback on and we should have
quite a cool effect. So I've got, right now I've got the two signals mixed. I'm using the synth bass through the Moog with the flashback on as well, the delay, so we get this kind of sound. About adding some other stuff in and taking it out, but that's pretty much it as it is at the minute. Hopefully you enjoyed this, not a lesson, but this demonstration of what I use. And if you haven't checked out Scott's Bass Lessons yet, do so. There's loads of wicked lessons on there, and if you subscribe, you'll get sent a load of exclusive videos as well and other goodies. So I'll see you soon, take it easy and get in the shed.